Hi, I'm Alex, I'm a PGA Golf professional and welcome to the channel. Okay, staying down through impact brings consistency in the game, and by the end of this video, you're gonna learn exactly how you can stay down through that impact with your irons and with your driver, because doing that is gonna help you hit better strikes throughout the round. And we all know, whatever handicap you are, that is the route to lower scores. So Nathan, we're gonna sort you out here. I know you need some help, my friend. Let's get it done. Now, first off, I've got this training aid out, but you don't actually have to use it. You could be brave and get a towel from home, roll it up. It's just something to go under the arch of your foot. Right, okay, what is standing up? There's two ways in which, when you come for a lesson with me down at Mottram Hall, I would explain it. Number one, it's sort of a line on top of your head and your head going through that line. The second one would be sort of a line on your bum, and as you're coming into the golf ball, your bum moving off that line, okay? Now, when you're not staying down through impact, you're actually leaking a lot of power and you're making that strike a little bit more in this fashion, increasing the likelihood of this club face closing, opening, basically less control. So there's two stages to this drill, and I would really pay attention to this. I said this in the past, and I mean this, like, there may be parts of this video you might want to just rewind, rewatch, pause, try it, and then do the second part. I think that's the best way of thinking about this. Right, so stand on your wedge, towel, whatever it might be. So you can see here, I can go heels, I can go toes, there's quite a bit of a difference. So if I'm standing up, a lot of people tend to go on their toes. What I want you to practice, hands across your chest, first off, start sort of on your heel slightly, turn, and as you're coming down, I want your left heel to be down and your right toe to be down, your right shoulder to be down. Watch this, practice this. And you know what? Just keep doing a few reps. While the kettle's on in the morning, get this feeling, because if we had the line on top of my head and the line on my bum, they'd be sitting rock solid. So it really gives you that feeling of helping you get that distinguished feeling of putting the weight this way and getting down on that golf ball, right? Might want to then jump off it, try that again. This is the feeling in which you're after. So what I would seriously recommend, you might think I'm crazy with this, but listen to this, right? I've said this to one of my lessons and he couldn't believe the difference. Every morning while you're making yourself a brew or your partner a brew, do that. 50 seconds, if that, 30 seconds every morning. Honestly, you won't believe the difference. You'll go to the range and then you can do the second part we're gonna do now, so much easier, right? So we know what we're after now. We know we're after this move. Left heel, right shoulder. Really feeling we work this way, not this way, right? So, what I want you to feel here is we're going to put our club out in front of us with your lead hand. So I'm a right-handed golfer, so I put it in my left hand. Okay, if you're left-handed, you would just do it in the way. Simple as like that. What I want you to do now is I want you to imagine you're gripping a golf club with your trail hand and put some speed into doing this. Really feels like you're trying to thud your right shoulder underneath your left arm. This is your feeling. Look at what I'm doing. I'm learning to rotate. I'm learning to organize my body. So when you come into a shot now, you're trying to replicate that feeling. You've done your homework, you've done your stretches, you've then got a bit more of a realistic feeling. So you can feel way more powerful. I mean, look at my position here. Down, through, up to a great finishing position. You honestly have to try that. So Nathan, I hope that helps you, but also hope that helps the rest of the golfers. Now, before you go, you'll notice I've got three brand new lovely Cobra drivers in my hand here. I've got a giveaway going on. You can choose which one you want. So subscribe to this channel, like this video, and get down in the comments what version you want, the LS, the X, or the Max. You know what? We all need a bit of a cheer up, don't we? The Masters is just over. Congratulations to the winner. Winner of this giveaway is announced this Sunday.